Dear students, welcome to lecture number 1 of Statistical Physics Paper 2. For simplicity, I have divided the contents of first lecture into few questions. First, we will define statistical mechanics. Then we will define statistical physics and how statistical physics works. There are two types of properties. One are the microscopic properties and other are the macroscopic properties. We will distinguish between these two properties with suitable examples. Knowing these properties, we will show that macroscopic properties are dependent upon the microscopic properties, and due to these two properties we will find two states. One is the microstate and other is the macrostate. And finally, we will explain that macrostate remains same while microstate changes with respect to time. Now, before defining the statistical mechanics, I will start from what is meant by statistics. So, what is statistics? Statistics means it is the systematic study of observations in order to determine the general behavior of systems from a limited number of such observations is called statistics. So, knowing the definition of statistics, we can define statistical mechanics, that it is the branch of physics which deals with the statistical predictions of the properties of a matter in bulk form from the knowledge of the particles of the constituent atoms or molecules and forces between the constituent atoms and molecules. So, finally, statistical predictions is sometimes restricted to the treatment of the system in equilibrium. So we will consider all the statistical mechanics in equilibrium state. Now, before describing or defining the statistical physics and how it works, we consider that why statistical techniques are important and why they are adopted. For this purpose, we consider gas contained in a container. And we suppose that there are 10 to the power 23 number of molecules present per unit volume. So to describe this system, we need 10 to the power 23 number of equations to describe the dynamics of every particle or the system, which is very difficult approach. So statistical techniques are required to describe this system. But first, we divide statistical physics into two properties which are important. So statistical physics divides the total properties of system into two types, and we first consider these two types. One are the microscopic properties and other are the macroscopic properties. Now, first we distinguish between two properties. One are the microscopic properties and other are the macroscopic properties. Great example. First, we consider what are microscopic properties. These are the properties which are associated with the individual constituents of the system. For example, position of the molecule, which is x, velocities of the molecule, v, momentum of the molecule, p, and number of collisions with the wall of the container, etc. So it is very difficult to describe a system with the help of such properties. Second are the macroscopic properties. These are the properties which are associated with the whole system. For example, total number of molecules in a gas, total volume of gas, total energy in a gas, temperature, etc. Macroscopic properties are those which reflect the microscopic properties. So in statistical, the statistical properties of a system are in general the macroscopic properties. And macroscopic properties are described as a function of microscopic properties. So we only need to know the relation between macroscopic variables and microscopic variable to describe the properties of the system or to do the prediction. So knowing the definitions of the macroscopic properties and microscopic properties, we are in a position to define statistical physics. It is the study of the macroscopic properties of the system in terms of microscopic properties. So macroscopic properties are studied in terms of microscopic properties, that is statistical physics. Another way, statistical physics is the investigation of the macroscopic properties on the basis of dynamical behavior of the constituent particles of the system. What is meant by dynamical behavior of the constituent particles of the system means in a system which contains large number of dynamical particles, atoms and molecules, and their behavior, which means microscopic properties of the constituent element. So from this definition gives us the answer how statistical physics works. There is a property of macroscopic variable that can be controlled from outside, but microscopic properties or variables cannot be controlled from the outside. Every macroscopic property is based upon a microscopic property. So microscopic properties depend upon the microscopic properties. So as I said that macroscopic properties are depending upon the microscopic properties, and it can be shown by considering the example of a gas contained in a container in a 3-dimension, and there are large number of atoms and molecules, and length or dimension of this cube is L. Or we focus on a motion of a one molecule moving along positive x axis, whose velocity is Vxi. After reflection from the face, this velocity is Vxi in the opposite direction. Negative sign shows the opposite direction of the velocity. So we can find the change in momentum from these velocities. Initial momentum before collision is MCxi. Final momentum after collision is minus MCxi, where M is the mass of the molecule or atom considered. Now therefore we can find the change in momentum in one collision, that is delta P, can be found by final momentum minus initial momentum, which gives us 2MCxi. Now according to definition of velocity, we can write F is equal to Vt, and from this we can find the time of travel of a particle from one side of the cube to the length up to L. So we can use length as 2L, total time travel between two successive collisions. So number of collisions per second, that is per second, 1 by T, it can be written as T over 2L. So change in momentum in 1 second, that is change in momentum per unit time, that is delta P by delta T, which gives the value of MCx squared divided by L. This last equation is giving us the rate of change of momentum, that is delta P by delta T, rate of change of momentum. And as we know that rate of change of momentum is equal to force according to Newton's second law in terms of momentum. So we can put this rate of change of momentum equal to force as F is equal to this. So knowing the force, we can find the pressure, that is force per unit area. We get the relation as this, and total pressure can be found by adding all the velocities of the particles along x-axis. So this gives us the total pressure along one axis, that is x-axis. Now we multiply the last equation by n and divide it by n, and the term in the bracket shows the total sum of velocities divided by total number of molecules or atoms. This gives us the root mean square velocity or average velocity, and it can be written as this. So this last equation is important. We show the relation between macroscopic property and microscopic property. This total pressure represents the macroscopic property, and this P, xi, which are the velocities of the individual particles along x-axis, and velocity, as we know, that is a microscopic property. So pressure, it depends upon velocities, and pressure is a macroscopic property, and velocities are microscopic properties, which shows that macroscopic properties are depending upon the microscopic properties. Secondly, this equation shows that pressure macroscopic property remains same while the velocities of the particles are not same. They are changing every time. So this equation is the elementary equation for the statistical mechanics. Now, as we have studied that there are two types of properties. One are the microscopic properties and other are the macroscopic properties. So therefore we have to define two states. One is the microstate and other is the macrostate. So first we define microstate. It is a state which can be described by the microscopic properties or microscopic variable, for example position, momentum, etc. And macrostate is a state which is described by the macroscopic variables, which are pressure, volume, etc. Now, knowing the two states, one is the macrostate and other is the microstate, we can explain that macrostate remains same while the microstates are changing continuously with respect to time. For this purpose, we again consider an ideal gas or gas contained in a container and there are large number and molecules in a gas. Suppose we focus on one molecule and we consider the position and momentum, etc. of this gas molecule, which are the microscopic properties, and these are changing with respect to time. They are not constant. Every time particles are changing its position and momentum, but the total pressure, volume, temperature, etc. These are the macroscopic properties, which are not changing with respect to time. So single macrostate, same macrostate, may contain large number of microstates, infinite number of microstates. Now finally, we conclude that to describe the system, macroscopic properties are used to control the system, while it is difficult to use the microscopic properties. And macroscopic properties or variables control the microscopic state of the system. And if we have an infinite number of macrostates, we will definitely have an infinite number of microstates. So finally, we say that microscopic variable changes the microstate. And it means that if we have a gas which has volume, temperature, pressure, volume, if we change the pressure, volume, temperature, these macroscopic variables, these will definitely change the microscopic properties, that is position, momentum, etc. So these control these. If we change the macroscopic properties, we will change the microscopic properties.